Hi, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about how to report other apps to Google Play if they're copying yours. Okay, so today I want to talk about what to do when somebody copies your app. I mean, this is something that's becoming more and more a problem for me. Like, last week we had to report three EarSpy copycats, right? And then as soon as we reported them, Google removed them, and then we have five more that we have to deal with. So it's become like a thing that we actually have a process for now. So we have Maribel on our team who goes through, and you know, every once so often she'll go through and do a search and find apps that are trying to copy ours. Sometimes they get really successful, so they'll show up. When we search for ours, they'll show up, you know, right next to ours, you know, and they do pretty well, but sometimes the similarity is too close to ours. Now, I'm not talking about, like, it's a similar idea, or it's, you know, somebody had, like, a similar idea as ours, or even one that's just sort of similar. Like, the idea is, if somebody copies the idea, I don't really care. If they copy the imagery and the name and the screenshots and everything about it, if it seems like they're trying to confuse users as to who the app belongs to, then that's something I take issue with, right? And that's something that we report from time to time. And so usually what happens is we'll start off with an email to the developer. We'll say, hey, I know you released this app called EarSpy with the red and black icon of the spy, and the screens look very similar to ours. And you're even using a lot of our description in your app description, like word for word. But, you know, we're asking you to remove that because, you know, so we don't have, you know, we're asking you to remove that because it's just too similar to ours. It's okay if it's in the same genre, right? Like if somebody released something that was a hearing aid app or something like that, or something that was spy related but wasn't called EarSpy and used the same category, the same everything, right? Same language and everything. And sometimes, most of the time, they won't respond. Sometimes they'll respond saying, I don't know what you're talking about. But we'll say, you know, we'll give you like, you know, 5 days or something. We say, we give you 5 days, and if it's still there, we're going to report to Google. And so that's what we end up doing. But the first time when I did this, I did a report to Google saying, hey, this app is very similar to ours. Here's our URL, here's their URL. And they came back and say, we don't see the similarities, so we have to, you know, we're going to deny that request. And I thought, okay, fine. But it was so similar. Like, it was almost hard to not see it because I knew what to look for. And other people, and the problem was other people were emailing me all the time saying, hey, did you know this is other app pretending to be you, right? And I thought, you know, or pretending to be your app. And I thought, yeah, I reported to Google, but, you know, there's nothing you could do. But I'm not that concerned because ours is way more successful than theirs. And then it just sort of started to gnaw at me a little bit because the fear was that if somebody was going to upgrade, or they're going to go the free to the paid version, and they were going to, you know, actually go and buy the full version, they might go to the wrong app and download that one, and then, you know, and then have a bad experience. And some of them were pretty dodgy. Like, people in the descriptions were talking about some of the things that they were doing with that app. So anyway, so now what we do is we have a look at my screen here. So this is the report alleged copyright infringement form, which I seem to be getting to know pretty well. The language here is pretty scary. Like, you know, you have to, you know, down here it says if you report something and it's not legitimate, then you could have your account suspended. So I was a bit, you know, skeptical to begin with before I went to go use this. But, you know, you go in here, put your name, company name, the full copyright holder name, email address, and then some of these other things. And then, you know, the app that's actually infringing, and then a description of what it is. So in the beginning, like I said, I would just say, this is that app. It looks too similar to ours. And I just very, you know, summarize what it is. And they came back and said, no, we're going to deny this request. So I thought, okay, that's fine. However, you know, after like 2 months, that app was gaining in popularity, and it just seemed kind of sleazy to me, and right, and it was just so similar to ours, right? Let me just, so what we did is I filled in another request and said, hey, I know you denied this request before, but I just want to iterate, you know, how similar it is. And this time I did a Google document with screenshots showing everything that was similar. So if you look at my screen here, this is what I sent them. I included this on the request. And the reason I used Google Docs was because you know, it's Google, and you know, they might, you know, appreciate the fact that I was using their technology. So here it is, you know, the same name, same description, you know, the icon similar. You know, I show the description here, like, you know, they're using the same, basically they just copied and pasted our description and made a few tweaks to it here and there, but it's, you know, some paragraphs were exactly the same as ours. And then, you know, here's is, you know, further down, the icon's very similar, the cat, it's in the same category, all this kind of stuff. And this seems to keep coming up over and over again. So that time they approved the request, and then like last week they approved all three requests, so. I just want to let you know that, because you might be in a situation where you have to do that. And one of the reasons why I do this now is because, I mean, you have to imagine that those people who do the Google, who check that, you know, they must get like loads of requests from different people, like, you know, that was my idea and somebody stole my idea, or, you know, that's, this is definitely a copy of mine, but it might not look any, it might be completely different, or might just have some similarities. Like I, you know, like I said, there's loads of apps that have taken what we have done and copied it, or maybe they even had the idea themselves and, you know, independently and went off and did it. But when, you know, sometimes they'll just they'll take the same name, the same description, the same keywords, the same everything, and that I consider to be too close to a copy. So, you know, where they're actually trying to fool people into thinking it's the same thing, or if it's somehow affiliated. So, and I, you know, I once had a client, well, it was a prospect, and he came to me, someone who would come to me with an idea. It was a unique idea, or so he thought. He said, this idea is totally unique. It's going to be, you know, it's totally awesome, right? And I've looked around and nobody's done this, right? And so the next day I was doing the quote, and I just did a quick Google Play search, and I found one pretty much the same as what he had said. And I sent it to him and said, this one seems to be similar to the idea you just had, right? It was just a simple search. And his thing was, he says, I told a few people about this. I think somebody probably copied my idea, right? And he was like trying to think of who could have betrayed him, right? And I think this is, you know, one of those, I'm sure if you work for Google as part of their legal department, you probably get these kind of requests all the time. Like, you know, I think somebody was listening to me talking to my wife about this idea and they just went off and copied it or something. So I mean, doing this kind of document where I just point out specifically, this is too similar, you can agree or disagree, but you know, these are my concerns, and then they could go and make that determination. So anyway, I hope that's been useful. Hopefully you guys don't have this kind of problem as often as I do, right? It's just, it's like whack-a-mole, but you know, every time you get one, another one pops up. But you know, hopefully it's been helpful. If you do have this kind of issue, hopefully I'll put the link to this this legal page in the description. And that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.